Hello all, let's continue with our sessions. So far we have seen how to work with Git repositories, how to debug Android efficiently. This is a small session. We will see how to write a markup document and export it to PDF and HTML. So far whatever documents you received, these three PDFs, they have been written in RHT only. So the entire session handouts which you have followed since morning, they all have written in RHT format, then exported to PDF. So you already know the importance of documentation, as we discussed in the morning, that before writing any meaningful code, you should first write a document of it, a readme of it. So many companies, in fact, they invest much more in preparing documentation than actually writing a code, because that actually creates a ecosystem of confidence. The user feel confident that the product which he is using, the application which he is using, is of some value to him. He's not getting lost somewhere. So in this session we will see. Okay, let's start with why documentation. Of course, almost all the projects, whether it's a Microsoft project or Google project, any project, they have excellent online and offline documentation. You probably know that in Windows have their help, Ubuntu have their help, in when you press F1 you get system help, command line you have man pages, --, help. So people do respect the code, people do respect the developer when he provides a good manual with the application. So we'll start directly with well-known tools already available for writing documentation which many people use. So I guess most of people are accustomed with Microsoft Office or Open Office, you can say, on GNU Linux environment. Both of these suites will allow user to export to PDF and HTML format, but you can't make a good CSS based document with these Office tools. Second one is LaTeX, which is very, very popular and very good typesetting language. Though it has a steep learning curve, but once you get used to it, you won't try anything else other than LaTeX. So the debugging LaTeX documents might be a little tricky, but of course once you get used to, LaTeX is best of among all these tools, even RHT also. Wiki language, you already know wiki text. If you have ever edited a wiki page, Wikipedia page, or wiki document based any websites, so they have their own markup, though you can export to HTML. I haven't heard of PDF export there. We will concentrate on ReStructured text, which appeared in 2002. It's again a lightweight markup language which is now very popular among open source developers, even in closed source developers also. So you can do lot more things which you have not heard of before. I will demonstrate few. Like suppose you want to write your PhD thesis, you can write in RHT. It will create a beautiful two column format with all embedded images, etc., etc. You can use it for that. You can write man pages, manual pages. You can write system help. You can write online HTML based help. You can write anything with ReStructured text. ReStructured text is nothing but a simple markups which, when rendered, produces the beautiful HTML or PDF. So far this document, this very document what you are looking now, is converted from ReStructured text .rht file, like we have seen readme.rht, and it has been converted to PDF. So there is a command in Linux, and probably it will work in Windows also because it's a Python based command. So rht to PDF is the command which we will see just right away. So by that you can convert it to PDF. That's it, that's simple. Okay, so next one is markdown language. Actually I think I did some indentation mismatch in RHT. RHT is very much indentation specific language, markup language. So I think there is some indentation mismatch between ReStructured text RHT and markdown MD, because the number should be 4 and 5. We will fix it to show you how it works. So the number should be 3, 4, 5. So markdown, it says 1. It should not be 1, it should be 5. Okay, we'll come to that. it's good that we have a bug in our document. So there is no need of any tutorial, as you know. See, this is a tool, a simple tool, like using a Gmail to edit your, to compose your mail. What you do, you use sometime quote tag, sometime you make it bold, sometime you use different tags, means you use a mouse cursor to click on particular tag, which enables it to enable that tag for you, which works in the background. In the restructured text, same thing happens, but instead of clicking something on a plain text file, no document format, no doc, no ODT, no such format, plain .txt form or .rst form. You write the document, you just convert it, and you are ready to go. We'll see in just in this next topic. So this is a ready to paste version of a document, which doesn't make any sense. This doesn't make any sense, because in this small document I want to show you as many RST tags as possible. When you build an PDF, you will know that which tag converted to which one. So as you can see, what I will do is I will just copy this to my text editor. That's it. I will copy. In fact, I have already copied it. I need to just go to that document. So vitemp.rst. So temp.rst contains this document. So this is the same content which we have just copied from this document. What it says, version control with double dotted lines. What if I miss one underline, one equals to? So when you compile this, how do you compile? Exit RST to PDF, there is a command, temp dot RST. So this is the command. So we already know that there is a document in a RST format in which we deliberately made a mistake. Let's see how RST treats that. So it says, warning, title underline is too small, too short, okay, but it converted, fine. So to view that document, we can simply do evince is a PDF viewer, temp.pdf. So this is our newly created temp.pdf. So the text which we have written in temp.rst is converted into this beautiful PDF format. So what was the text? Let's compare the text now. Let me open a new terminal, vitemp.rst. So you can see that version control, of course, with warning it compiled. So this is the heading. It says contents git version control with simple hello world project. I have taken the similar same document of git version control and stripped down to one page format, though totally meaningless, but just to show how tags are arranged here. Instead of breaking page here, I rather decided to make it continue. So if you compare with this, this says dot dot space contents colon colon. This is a syntax for directives. The directives means these are the plugins, kind of plugins. So one can write a RST document, a beautiful simple RST document with these plugins, which will allow him to write many things. Means, see, the contents, this first line will convert all the header tags, means all the headlines. Like this is a headline, means this is a topic, topics, subtopics. It will compile every topic and subtopic into bold letters, headings. So see, you can see this is a git version control with simple hello world project. That 1.1 is pushing a project to server, takes automatically. So where is our 1.1? We haven't mentioned any 1.1 here. Just by mentioning tildes, underline, as underline, we convey to RHT that this is a subheading. This is not the main heading, this is a subheading. Like you can see, the Git version control is with dotted lines. So it has been converted into heading, and one next to it has the tildes, which is converted into subheading. Again, if you give other headlines like this, then it will convert into subheading. Okay, so how this text box appear in this format? So all you have to do is use indentation. See, hash dot will be converted into point number 1. So hash will be auto numbered. So if you have hash dot 3 points, it will be 1, 2, 3. Okay, so create a directory, say hello world. Hello world will be in italics now. In your home, this will be turned into also italics directory and cd. Then with double colons, you are telling RHT that okay, whatever the topic comes next, it will be shifted. Means it will be a text box, it will be a message box kind of. Then mkdir hello world, if I make this here, as you can see, the syntax also changes, means the highlight also changes. And if I save it and compile it, means convert it, RHT to PDF, temp.rht, it says again a warning, literal block expected, none found, because we have changed the literal block. It expects the indentation, we remove that indentation. So let's see how our, so create a directory, say hello world in our home directory and cd. This make directory didn't come in the literal block, it disappeared, it just came as a plain text. We don't want this, so let's move it back so that I have provided one tab space, so it will now move to a literal block this way. Save and exit, RHT to PDF. One warning still there because we have omitted one equal to sign from that underline. So now the literal block is back. So all you have to do is give double colons after any statement. After that, whatever you write in an indentation form, it will be turned into a literal block. See, it seems little complex now, but when you actually see the documentation and do side by side, right, it is very, very easy. I wrote all three documents in probably 2 days, and that too, I was not continuously working on the documentation. Similarly, these stars will turn into bullets. So this star means it will be a bullet number, a bullet. One can access code from anywhere, easy to add, remove. If I change this star to hash, so now it will become numbered. Previously it was bullets. If you see here, previously it was bullets. Now I change the star to hash, and if I compile back, now it becomes 1, 2 instead of bullets. You follow? Fine. You can add images also. It's very simple to add images. I have added plenty of them. How to add an image? Very simple. If you want to add an image inline, like if you remember this document, we have a Git logos here. Okay, assuming Git is already installed on your machine. So what I did, I inserted a logo in between a text. This is also possible. How? Just use dot dot directive. These syntaxes are there in one manual page. I have provided a link below. You have to just follow the manual page whenever you need a certain command. This logo.png is the mark, means text. This is replaced by data slash logo.png, and the width of the image is scaled down to 30%, so on and so forth. Similarly, if you want to add a regular image, all you have to do is dot dot space image colon colon. See, this syntax is constant, means dot dot space any directive name. There are tons of directives, like you can add image, you can add warnings, you can add help, you can add many things, means whatever which communicates to user, there are some directives available to that. you don't have to remember any of these tags. Just search in the manual, it will be there, copy paste, that's it. So this is the code block directive. Code block directive will make your code look as a, it will format your code, add this line numbers, will add line numbers to your code. So you can see as we have changed our thing, so it didn't appear. What I will do is, let's fix this. Let me do it again. Why don't we fix this also? So it will convert neatly. And there is a literal block here, as decided collaborator will follow content. So let's remove that literal block. So all you need is rst2pdf command, which you can download with Ubuntu apt-get install rst2pdf, or download the source, which the link I have already provided above. So this is a sample screenshot of the output, what you will receive there. Directives we already discussed. So dot dot image colon colon logo dot png is a directive. So these are the similar to attributes to any class. So these are your options available with this particular directive. Indentation is important. As you have just seen, with improper indentation we lost our formatting. So indentation is important, and you should stick to one kind of indentation. Suppose you are choosing four spaces for a tab, you should stick with four spaces only. You should not use four spaces for one page, eight spaces for next page, it won't work. So the next part is converting RST files into HTML. You can directly convert RST to HTML. There is a command RST to HTML, which just converts this temp dot RST to say 1.html with some this literal block error, no problem. We can open this HTML in our browser and we can go through. But there is a better way of converting into HTML. That's what I want to convey. Instead of converting into plain HTML, which of course will have some CSS, we have a package known as Sphinx, Python Sphinx, which is very, very popular and very easy to work with. All you have to do is install Python Sphinx from here, sudo apt-get install Python Sphinx, or you can download, this is a Python package, you can download from PyPy, Python server, and you can easily install it. How to start? Sphinx quick start you have to do. What I will do, I will, this is a directory in which I have created all my files from yesterday, adb and busybox.rst, git intro.rst, rst-pdf sphinx.rst. All these source files are available in my GitHub account, which you have already know, github.com/srikantpatnaik. So you can download these RST files if you want to refer it further. So what I want to do is, I want to convert these RST files into Sphinx, Sphinx documentation. Sphinx is a pre-formatted, well-suited document representation form, specially written for Python, but you can use it for anything. So it will ask you step of yes or not, no type of questions, which almost you have to say yes for all, enter like that. I have already done this yesterday, no need of doing it again. All I have to do is open index.rst, which will, when you do yes, yes to all those questions, it will create a index.rst in your present working directory. In this index.rst, I have mentioned my three files, git-intro, adb and busybox rst-pdf sphinx without the extension. If you see, I have not mentioned any extension here. So this, when I compile, make HTML, it will create HTML files within say 15 to 20 seconds, not more than that, and it will be available in /build HTML. So all my files are available here. If I want to see how my RST files look as HTML, you can open it like Google Chrome. I use Chrome frequently, so Google Chrome. Where is my index.html? index.html. So when I hit enter, so it says welcome to Android workshop IIT Bombay documentation. So this is very easy to browse. You can have, you have quick search here, you have topics listed, everything is in line, version control, first topic, subtopics also listed, advanced Android debugging, all of them are available, restructured text, everything is there. Let's see how a busy box look. That's it. So it has been converted into HTML in no time. So what I have done, I have written all my documents in plain text format, then depending upon my need, I converted into PDF and provided to you for further study. If I want to put this online, which I did yesterday night, you can go through this from anywhere. Just go to it.iitb.repo.html. So I uploaded this on this URL yesterday night so that I can show you during the session. So this link, if you want to access, you can access from your own local machine. Let me, so this is the URL. You can just visit this URL and you can find out how the PDF document which you have in your machine looks when you convert it into HTML. So the same RST file has been converted into HTML. So you go to version control, you have complete details as you would have written in HTML, Y version control, everything is linked. Your literal boxes come properly. You have line numbers, as we have mentioned, colon line numbers for directive. For me, it's very easy and straightforward. Means most of the documents, I want to show one more link, akashlabs.org/docs. So this is the documentation which we made for our project. So we made Aakash Programming Lab, so which essentially provides you Scilab, C, C++ and Python programming tools on Aakash tablet. So we have written complete offline as well as online documentation for developer as well as user also. So it took us, yes, lot of time, but it's worth making this documentation. You can see this document, it's very simple, user manual. Let's see user manual, how it looks, how to use it. So this is how our application looks. So this is text area, console output, etc. So we have written it in plain RST, same as like we have written for this thing. You want to see source, you can see source, show source. It will directly print your RST source file on your browser. That simple. We have created a document for Linux on Aakash also. Docs. So we have ported GNU Linux on Aakash tablet, which can essentially run from micro SD card. So it's good to have a complete online and offline document for this process what we have done, because probably this is very unique moment for us that complete GNU Linux is working on Aakash. So we decided to make full document for that, that how to set up everything you need, how to compile kernel, how to compile SD card, etc. This all information is available on our GitHub account, Android portal, github.com/AndroPortal. Why I'm showing all this, because see, means it is very easy for us to generate a very professional quality documentation using simple plain text in RST format. All you need to do is just go through these links, this docutils.sourceforge.net, is the official hosting for this package. You can find quick reference, restructured text, etc. And that's almost everything for this session. So if you have any questions, quick questions, you can just ask me. Someone has requested me to show how to install application using ADB. So let me do it. So you can see there is an fdroid.apk is there, and my Android debugging is already on, and I can show you. So our debug connection is back. So I'm just replying to question that ADB install APK name, say suppose fdroid.apk will install this APK on my tablet. Suppose this APK is already installed and I want to install it again without losing its data, I will use hyphen R flag. Success. So same thing you can do with your emulator also. So you just when you connect to your emulator, just do ADB devices to verify whether your emulator is connected or not. It will show that emulator is connected. Then you can just do ADB install whatever application you want. One topic I mentioned before, like license. So but I didn't cover license. I hope it's not that difficult for you to find out how a license look and what exactly licenses are. So I will give you a brief, very brief introduction for license. So I basically followed this web page, if you can see. So I agree with this data, that's why I'm showing it. So I thought it's not relevant to make another document for just license. It's very simple topic. Mostly you should do with open source license, of course. When we say open source, the first license come in our mind is GNU GPL. So GNU is the main project which says that any license, any source code when you release, it should give freedom to user to modify, to redistribute, and to respect the user's name. Means suppose I have downloaded some GNU license, GNU application, if I want to redistribute or modify the source code, I should modify on these terms. That means I should mention the name of the author, original author, then I should redistribute, etc. This is very simple to understand. All you need to understand is what kind of freedom you want to give to your users when you when you choose some license. So most commonly used licenses are GNU GPL version 2, because version 3 have some differences which Linus Torvalds doesn't agree. So version 2 is most popularly used. Apache license is also very open license. You can do whatever with code that you want. You can even close your further branches also. Suppose in GNU license, GNU GPL license, you are forced to release source in open only. You are forced to release open source only, later modifications. But consider this BSD license. It doesn't force you to do that. Suppose you have, like, if you consider Macintosh, they also took source code from Unix, okay? Then they modified their version of operating system and they made it closed source, okay? They based on BSD license. So BSD license give you freedom to user that, okay, you download my source, you want to release that open source, okay? If you don't want to, no, we don't have any problem. So BSD license give you freedom. Of course, many open source people don't agree with BSD license. So by default, if you want to invoke any license in your project, that you should do, of course, you should include a GNU GPL version 2 license or any license, whatever you study better, you can use. So that's all about this session. Before closing this session, I want to convey to you people that if you have not already switched to GNU Linux, it's the right time to switch, because there are many open source projects, there are lot of demand for open source developers. There is Firefox OS known as Gecko, there is Tizen project, which is again an open source project, mobile platform and tablet platform. There is Ubuntu for tablet, Ubuntu for phone. Of course, Android is there. So almost all major computing devices, almost 75 to 80% of web servers version some variant of Linux operating system. So the future belongs to Linux based developers. So you can try both, means you can have Windows as well, and for development you should of course try with Linux. Of course with Android development it's easy to develop Android application on Linux platform rather than Windows platform. Thank you all. I hope you have enjoyed these sessions.